Well then. Come on.
Yes. I got this book from a company called Elector. Now, I'm not promoting the book, but if you go to Elector's website. Oh, sorry, do I need this as well? Oh. I don't know.
Hello.
Oh, right. Hello. Right. I got this book. The company selling it and publishing it is a company called Elector. They're an electronics magazine company. And if you go on their website and you select books, and you select RPI books, you'll come across this book. It's 45 electronic projects. Towards the bottom of the page advertising the book, you will find a zip folder, and it says Raspberry Pi software. Now, you don't need to buy the book to download this software, so you can download the software onto your PC and unzip it, and you'll find actually it contains lots of PC software. One of the things it contains is a software package that allows you to make an image of your Pi's SD card and store it on your PC's hard drive. So if you ever have a situation where you corrupt your SD card, you can simply make a new copy of it. If you want to make a clone of your SD card, then you have to make sure your SD card is exactly the same as the one that you've, your master SD card, just for the same manufacturer, as well as the same size. The next piece of software is PuTTY, which I don't know, most people should be aware of it. It's a useful little program. It allows your PC to communicate with your Pi. So your Pi, all you need to do is connect a power supply to your Pi, and you can access PuTTY, providing you know it's Wi-Fi code. You can access it and run it. But you can only run it as command line. You can't use graphics, unfortunately. One of the advantages of PuTTY, of course, is you can have more than one PuTTY screen open. So, for instance, if you've got two Raspberry Pis talking to each other, you can actually access both of your Raspberries on one PC, and you can actually program them both at the same time. The other piece of software that's on this in the zip file is a file manager, which allows you to drag and drop files from your PC onto your Pi quite easily and quite simply, just like the normal Windows file manager, which I find extremely useful. And there's also an oscilloscope, which uses your PC sound card as an oscilloscope, but I've never had any success getting it to work. And then the other things are examples containing the book, and if you don't buy the book, they're not really much use to you. But certainly the software that comes with the book I found very useful. And if you want to know how the software works, I can tell you. The other thing I was going to mention was Liverpool.
So the last time you came here and you said, why are there no Raspberry Pi events in Liverpool? I said, you just need to go and find the community. So
Yes, Liverpool. Yes, because when you look at the jam map, there's a big hole where Liverpool is. There's nothing there for some reason. And you think, being a big city, there should be something. So there is something similar, and it's called DOES?
It does,
that's it. And it's a group that meets once a week on a Thursday night between 6 and 9. And it's not like this, it's a hands-on group where everybody making their own projects. There are plenty of facilities available. There's a laser cutter which will cut perspex and wood so you can make nice cases for your Pi projects. There's also a 3D printer. There's two 3D printers, in fact. And there's lots of other equipment that you can use, that you can freely use. It's all free. And as well as being on a Thursday night, there's also they have one event per month on a Saturday. It's well worth going to if you're in Liverpool. It's just around the corner from John Lewis. If you want to know exactly where it is, I'll tell you if you need to know. I can give you the exact directions.
That's great. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you.